Well, good morning, young scientists. I'm Michelle Roy. I'm the science coordinator at Kern County Superintendent of Schools, and I am excited to be with you this morning working on a do-at-home science experiment. Today, our essential question that we'll be investigating involves the question there that you see on your screen. Will ice cubes melt faster in salt or fresh water? This experiment involves some very simple, easy to get items that you have in your home. In order to do the experiment, you'll need two clear plastic containers, which I'm suggesting plastic, about 8 ounces each. But the honest truth is you can use a couple of glasses as well, or hard plastic, whatever you have in your house. And then a cup of fresh water, a cup of salt water, some ice cubes. It needs to really be ice cubes, not shaved or really small grainy ice. Ice cubes work best, and you'll see why once we actually do the experiment. And then a bottle of food coloring. And I'm going to be demonstrating the experiment today with blue, but really any color of food coloring will work. So to do the experiment, let's take a look at this. We will be using a cup labeled with salt water and a cup of fresh water, as I've already got set up. We'll have some ice cubes. And the experiment begins with putting a couple of ice cubes in the fresh water and a couple of ice cubes in the salt water, both at the same time. And then we'll just observe what happens when we put those ice cubes in there. And we'll do that for 3 minutes. And as you're observing for the 3 minutes, it'd be great if you could jot down some observations in your notebook, and you might draw some pictures as well around what do you see going on in the two containers. And then after about 3 minutes, what we're going to do next is take our blue food coloring and drop a couple drops of blue on top of the ice cubes, and we'll observe and see what happens. It would be really great if you could grab a few family members as well to observe along with you, and talk with you a little bit about, have some discussions in your family about what you think is going on in the two cups. As you're observing, not only as you're watching the ice melt, but then what happens once you put the food coloring on top of the ice. And so as you're observing, here are some things you might want to talk about with your family members as you're observing. What did you notice about the melting rate of the ice cubes in the two systems? How did the two systems function differently? So we're saying that in each cup, that cup is considered a system. And so what we're going to be comparing is the fresh water system with the salt water system. And what are you noticing that's different about the two systems? And what do you think was happening that you can see? Start to consider maybe some whys. And what do you think is happening in those cups that you cannot see? Which really gets us to start to think about some of the why as to what's going on in those cups. And so the science behind what is actually going on. So there are definite links to the California Next Generation Science Standards and what we're doing today. This activity is a great opportunity to begin conversations around the melting polar ice caps as a result of climate change. A lot of that does have to do with this interaction of the big icebergs that are up there and what's happening. I don't want to give anything away just yet about the experiment, but what happens in our experiment is actually what's happening up at the Arctic North, where we're seeing some change in the polar ice, and a lot of that is due to this mixing of fresh and salt water. And this activity directly ties to our California middle school curriculum. In particular, this is an activity that comes from the sixth grade California Science Standards, but can certainly be tailored to any age group. There's certainly something here for everyone, but definitely this is what you would expect to see in a sixth grade classroom in California. Let's do our experiment. Just so you know, both cups are at room temperature. The temperature in the two cups is the same. I've got some ice from my freezer, and I've also got my blue food coloring, just because we tend to, to replicate that watercolor that we see out in nature. And then I've also got my paper towels, because we might make a mess. So make sure you've got some paper towels on hand to clean up any water that might get dropped. So it's critical. I've got my ice, as it's been sitting here, has melted just a little bit. So I've got to dig a bit and find, I'm going to find some ice cubes that are about the same size. And I want to put in the same amount. So what I'm doing is going with three ice cubes in each cup, and I'm going to drop kind of lightly and not stir there. And then we just observe what's going on and set a timer for about 3 minutes. And then this is the part where I suggest that you grab some family members and have some conversations about what you notice is going on in the two cups. So if I move that a little closer, get a little better view there. All right. I think I already notice that in the fresh water, I'm already starting to see, particularly this center ice cube, seems to be really disappearing. So in your houses, I'd let this sit for about 3 minutes and see what happens. But here in my test kitchen science spot, if you will, we're going to go ahead and move along with our experiment and grab my food coloring, got my blue food coloring here, and I'm going to drop just a couple little drops on top of my ice. One, two. And on top of the ice here, same amount. So check it out. And you know, in science, we like to ask those two famous notice and wonder questions. What do you notice? And what do you wonder about what is happening in these two cups? And you know, right now, I'm noticing a definite difference in what's going on in the two cups, right? So I'm noticing that in our freshwater cup, when I dropped the blue food coloring on top of that ice, it sunk right away versus in my salty water. Let's see, you can see that it's the food coloring is still just sitting right there on top. And it definitely has, it's spreading. The blue food coloring is spreading a bit, but I haven't, there's absolutely, well, I guess I know there's a little couple stray drops of color that have sunk to the bottom, but the majority of that blue food coloring continues to sit on top of that salty water. And so it would be interesting to let these sit for a while and see if anything changes. One of those videos that I showed you at the end of the slide presentation actually suggests letting the experiment sit for a bit and then actually adding another color of food coloring in to see what happens then. But you definitely now can see here the example, the demonstration, if you will, of what I was describing around the, in the fresh water, the cold, icy water sank to the bottom and that warmer water rose to the top, which created the mixing in our freshwater cup. Whereas over here in our salt water, we've got that cold, icy water still just sitting up on top because the salty water is actually more dense than that cold fresh water. You know, ice is fresh water sitting there on top, literally providing almost like this nice cushion for that food coloring to just sit on. So I'm a super curious scientist. So I'm wondering if I let these two systems sit for another hour or even for the rest of the day, if you will, I'm wondering about this saltwater cup. And I'm wondering if there ever would be a point that this food coloring, this less dense layer of fresh water sitting on top of this more dense salty water, if it might ever sink, or if there might end up being some mixing like in our fresh water cup. But that's something that I'm going to let you ponder and let you test at home. And so the, you know, what is going on in the cups? And so if we think about the freshwater cup, you can take a look at my diagram here. So we've got the freshwater cup where the ice melted faster than in the salt water. You'll notice there's some definite mixing going on. We've got the cold water, which is more dense than the warm water. So we've got the cold water sinking and the warm water rising, which is why we got that food color. You noticed that the food coloring was sinking down to the bottom. And then we had this sort of mixing going on, as opposed to in our salt water, where the ice melted much more slowly than in the freshwater cup. And we actually observed a layer of blue food coloring just sitting on top. And that's due to the fact that the salty water is actually the salty water is more dense than that cold water sitting on top. And why would it be more dense? Because it's so full of salt. So it actually is as if that cold fresh water is lighter, more buoyant, if you will, sitting on top of that salty water down below. And it literally sits on top. And we've also got that salty water slowing down the melting of the ice, very much like if you've ever made ice cream at home. We put that rock salt on our ice as we're making our ice cream to keep the ice from melting so fast. It's the same idea here. And so if you're interested in going further or learning more about today's experiment, I've actually got a couple of videos here for you to watch. If you watch this first video, this really awesome teacher actually does the same experiment that I'm going to take you through, but he goes further with it and actually adds some other variables to the experiment. And he actually adds in some thermometers to actually track temperature as we're comparing the melting of the ice in the two cups. So if you're wanting to do more, check out this video or, whoops, didn't mean to start that, as well as this second video where, again, it's the same basic experiment that we're going to be doing together, but she actually goes a different direction at the end as well with some things that you might also want to try at home. Plus, there's just some really great extra learning that goes on in these two videos. It's been a lot of fun doing science with you. Good luck trying this out at home.